Hello, I am Mihai Rus from stuparul.ro. We are in 17th of May 2020 and we are preparing to extract the acacia honey. We had quite good harvest. The weather was very good in the first week. We have harvested on the scale about 40 kilograms of honey. Here is the hive with a scale. The hives had about three supers each from the start. The ones which needed more space got the fourth at the end of the first week. But in the second week we had a drop of 15 degrees from 26 to 11 from one day to the other, to the next. It was a big drop and we started to get minuses on the scale, and just now in the last days we started to get pluses, so we kind of get zero on the second week. So this was the weather. We are having we have two supers of kept honey for each hive, no more than that. So what we are going to do today, we are going to place this I really don't know the word in English, so if you can help me, just write in the comments. I will also look for it and try to use it in the next movies. So it's a device, let's say, to let the bees retreat from the supers with honey into the hive, but cannot get back. So this is what we are going to use, and we will leave the uncapped supers for the bees to complete. So just the two capped supers we are going to extract. Today we place these devices, and tomorrow or in 48 hours there will be no bees in the supers on top of them, so we can come and harvest them. It's a nice way to harvest. You do not need a lot of smoke, and you do not bother the bees, and they can continue harvesting without any problem. Let's see what we have in the hives and how we place this escape boards. It might be the good term for them, if I remember correctly. So it's escape boards, I think they are named. Okay, this is the usual hive that I present. It's not the biggest, and it might not be the biggest because it made a super seizure. I don't know if I'm expressing it correctly, but they exchanged the old queen with a new one without the interference of the beekeeper. So this is the last super, the third, and as I was telling you, it does not have kept honey and is not very full. Almost full. So this we will leave for some more days to be processed, while the other supers are kept or partially kept. You can see inside also, and we will place the escape boards so that we can move the bees from these two supers. If this one is like this, the other one should be better, because they start to gather honey and cap it from bottom to top. This is what I have observed. So let's place the escape board. Okay, so I have placed the third super on the queen excluder, and now we place the escape board on top of it. You can see what I'm using. It has 12 exits, and in fact the bees descend through this hole and get out on one of the 12th exit, and when they want to climb again in the top supers, they will see that aeration, and they will try to enter through there, and they will be tricked not to be able to get in the upper supers. So what happens? The upper supers remain without bees. Okay, so yeah, I have some propolis there, and it does not fit correctly. These skateboards are made by me from scrap wood that I found at home, and this is the first super. Let's see how the honey looks like. Yeah, so they have started to cap it, and I think they have tried to let to make space for the queen to climb and put some eggs here, but the queen cannot pass through the queen excluder, so they fill that space with honey in the end. The same, yeah, but it's good honey. Almost all the frames are new frames. This one, for example, it's a foundation from 2020, which was built and almost kept. So I'm sure that the honey is processed. Here in the on the side, the frames are fully kept. Okay. So now we just have to put these two supers that we want to extract on top, and come after 24 or even better 48 hours to get the frames with honey. So this is how the done job looks like. So we have the nest, queen excluder, the box, the super with the unkept honey, and the two supers with the kept honey which we want to extract. The smaller hives you see near the big ones are the helper families which I have taken down before the acacia harvest. So all the flying bees were caught by the big hive, the production hive, and I have also given some of the frames with the kept root from the helper family to the production hive to make a big family which can harvest a lot of honey. The helper families remain here. They are held with syrup if necessary, and they will be used again in the next harvest chestnut in 3 or 4 weeks. So we will continue with the next one, the hive on the scale. I have cracked it open. It has four supers. The super on top was added just at the end of first week, so they did not have enough time to complete it, but they are starting to complete it, and they also got a lot of foundations in this box. These are recycled plastic foundations which they start to build. Recycled in the sense that they were used one cycle when they were new, and now I have taken down the old comb and cleaned them and waxed them again and put them again in the hive to be used. Here I think we might have a nice surprise. So if you look at the third super, it quite looks kept. It looks quite kept, and it is. And what I have learned, if the last super looks it's kept, then also the supers beneath it are kept. So here we don't have just two supers with honey, we have three, and they look even better. So three supers of 12 frames with honey. This is the second one. It also looks kept. So very, very good jobs, girls. Thank you for this nice harvest. Here they have tried to leave some space for the queen to lay, I think, but with no success. Let's see this new frame. This is foundation from 2020. It's built and almost kept. Yeah, so this is the harvest from acacia for 2020. The mean, I think it's two boxes of kept honey per hive. Of course, yeah, we have cases with three, and these are the doubles which I have splitted before acacia. They were on top of these hives. I took them down. They lost the flying bees, and they did not produce a lot in the rape harvest, but they produced one box of kept honey in the acacia harvest. So I'm just going to do the same thing here, to put the escape board, and come after 1 day or 2 days to get the frames with honey with no bees. Thank you a lot for watching, as always. I wish you good luck in your seasons, wherever you are in the world. And so good luck to have a good weather, to produce a lot of honey, and good health to you all. Bye-bye.